What are the differences between hair shedding, hair thinning, hair loss, and hair fall?
Hair loss is a common issue for both men and women. Seeing more hair in the hairbrush or the shower floor or the drain can be very distressing. We see patients every day in our practice who are anxious to understand if they are permanently losing their hair. Patients we see often use terms like hair shedding, hair thinning, hair loss, and hair fall to describe their situation. I'll discuss these terms to help you understand these terms and situations where there is potential long-term hair loss, as well as treatments I recommend in my practice. I'm Dr. Amiya Prasad. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I've been helping patients with genetic pattern hair loss throughout my career with surgical hair transplantation and medical therapies such as finasteride and minoxidil. In 2011, I recognized a remarkable side effect of a wound healing material we used to improve our hair transplant surgical results called acellular matrix with PRP, which resulted in reactivation of hair growth and thickening of thinning hair. I developed protocols based on my results with different formulations and techniques and developed the hair regeneration system for male and female pattern hair loss. I founded TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers to help make this treatment system geographically much more accessible. Patients come to our offices for TrichoStem Hair Regeneration from around the world. The most common concern for people who are experiencing hair shedding is the possibility they are experiencing permanent hair loss. According to the medical literature, it's normal to shed 50 to 100 hairs a day. This is usually not perceivable because of the rate of hair regrowth. Individual hairs continuously grow for 2 to 6 years, a period called the anagen phase. About 88 to 90% of all your hair follicles are in the anagen phase, so most of your hair is growing and visible at any given time. Hair eventually stops growing temporarily, but only 8 to 10% of hairs do this. When hair stops growing, it enters into a short transitional phase called catagen, when the hair shaft starts to separate from the hair follicle or root. This transitional phase lasts about 4 weeks. The hair then sheds in a phase called telogen. Telogen is also the resting phase where the follicle doesn't produce hair for about 3 to 4 months. After the telogen phase, the hair growth cycle starts again with the anagen phase, and the hair grows from the same follicle. Hair shedding, where 200 or more hairs a day are shed, is often associated with a temporary hair loss condition. For example, hormonal effects from oral contraceptives or hormonal changes before and after childbirth can be the basis for hair shedding. Generally, hair which sheds remains viable with the hair follicle still intact and functional, so the hair grows back. A common form of hair shedding is called telogen effluvium. Commonly, telogen effluvium is due to a stressful event that occurred 2 to 5 months prior to hair shedding. Events that trigger telogen effluvium are often highly stressful periods, such as undergoing general anesthesia, extensive surgery, death in the family, divorce, or hospitalization. There is a condition called chronic telogen effluvium, which mostly affects women and is not directly associated with a singular stressful event. Chronic telogen effluvium is characterized by constant and significant hair shedding with some relative stability in the density and overall scalp coverage. There is no direct treatment for telogen effluvium, so you just allow for time to let the hair grow back. Hair shedding is commonly caused in both men and women who also undergo cancer treatment, as the effects of chemotherapy results in stopping of the active growth phase and is referred to as anagen effluvium. intervention is usually not necessary, as the hair usually grows back after chemotherapy is completed. We've had some patients report that their hair quality never came back to the way it was before undergoing chemotherapy. Hair thinning is defined as a progression where hair density diminishes and individual hairs after normal shedding come back thinner. Eventually, the hair follicle disappears altogether. In male pattern hair loss, a contributing variable to hair thinning is the scalp sensitivity to DHT or dihydrotestosterone. Another aspect of male pattern hair loss is the possibility of having a genetically programmed limit to the number and longevity of hair growth cycles. The drug finasteride is used to reduce DHT. It allows for prolongation of the hair growth cycle. However, it has limited value in the stimulation of hair growth. Further, we've observed many patients who have been on finasteride for over 15 years who still progressively lost a significant volume of hair. This doesn't mean that the finasteride didn't work. It just means that there are other variables which cause or contribute to hair loss to continue in spite of being on the drug. More than likely, the same individual would have had much less hair if they weren't on the finasteride. Female pattern hair loss is much more common than is generally acknowledged. Affecting 50% or more women over 50, there can be some association with decrease in estrogen as well as genetic factors. Female pattern hair loss is diffuse, which leads to a decrease in hair density, resulting in widening of the hair part, described as a Christmas tree pattern. The term hair fall is commonly used in South Asian countries to mean awareness of hair loss, which can be caused by hair shedding and genetic pattern hair loss. As mentioned earlier, I developed a treatment for male and female pattern hair loss based on observations of improved scalp coverage during hair transplant in areas not transplanted when we used PRP or platelet-rich plasma with acellular matrix produced by the company Acell. Since 2011, I found ways to combine these materials and develop algorithms, which I refined over the years based on the responses I saw. TrichoStem Hair Regeneration is not just an injection treatment. I create customized treatment plans for male and female pattern hair loss patients based on the patient's gender, age, age of onset of hair loss, degree of hair loss, and any prior medical treatment used for hair loss. Although a large percentage of our patients have done well for over 5 years with only one treatment session, patients who have moderate to advanced hair loss may receive an additional treatment about 18 months or so after the first treatment to maximize scalp coverage. Sustained hair growth and thicker hair has been seen for 3 to 5 years or even more with this treatment strategy. Our patients don't need to come in for injections every month or every 3 months for the treatment to be effective. We follow our patients with standardized digital photography and microscope photos every 3 to 6 months for the duration of the treatment plan and yearly thereafter. We have achieved visible and long-term improvement in hair thickness, density, and coverage in over 99% of our patients. When it comes to experiencing hair loss, proper diagnosis and optimal management can make a big difference for your long-term outlook. We live in a time where people are being sold hair loss treatments where the practitioner or vendor makes no commitment to your long-term management. If you're experiencing hair loss and you're considering a procedure, find a doctor who will perform a thorough evaluation, show you before and after photos of their patients, and provide you with a rational treatment plan which you can have confidence in. I hope you found this information helpful. Thank you for your question.